In this video, I'll talk a little bit about the periodic variation in physical properties of the elements. I'm referencing in this video a table found on ptable.com. The first property I want to talk about is the atomic radius of an atom of any given element. This table is color-coded so that dark green is a larger atomic radius and light green is a smaller atomic radius. So counterintuitive, because I say counterintuitive because as we move to the right, the molar masses are larger, but as we move to the left, the size of the atoms, the atomic radius, it gets larger. So even though the oxygen, molar mass of oxygen, is larger than the molar mass of nitrogen, nitrogen actually has a larger atomic radius, 75 picometers using the covalent method versus 73 picometers for oxygen. By the way, the covalent method is simply half the distance between the centers of the atoms in these diatomic molecules, or half the distance between the centers of the atoms in these metals, when the atoms are all close together in the middle. Now, when we talk about the ions of these elements, something peculiar happens. Well, aluminum or the metals, when they form ions, they lose electrons. So you can think of it as losing size. They lose electrons out of their outer shells. You could think of it that way. And so when they're losing size, the Al3 plus has lost 3 electrons. So even though its atom, not the ion, but just the atom, aluminum, has a larger atomic radius than, say, chlorine, when they form ions, Al3 plus is actually smaller than Cl minus. Chlorine has gained an electron to form the ion Cl minus. Now, something that is agreed upon is the melting point. I mean, that is, we have definite melting points for these elements. Now, we don't know all of the elements here down at the bottom, but the general trend is that towards the center and down, the melting points get higher, and towards the outside and up, the melting points get lower. So we've got some anomalies like carbon up here, but you can think of this as being true. The metals, you could think of that as being harder to melt, so that makes intuitive sense. And you've heard of liquid nitrogen or liquid oxygen and liquid hydrogen, and these are very cold, so their melting point is very, very low. So those are just some of the properties and how they're arranged geographically on the periodic table. I hope that was helpful. If you did find this helpful, consider liking it or sharing it with a friend.